Hey everyone, and happy Monday to you. I wanted to bring you another just a quick video today to encourage you in a few areas. I hope that your family is doing well. We are excited about being back in church. And for those of you that have been watching us on YouTube, we've been getting really good feedback from that. I hope you're spreading those videos around, sending those links around, because it's Reformation time. It really is. And oh, by the way, thank you for the very kind feedback as well concerning our name change. For most of you that I've talked to, you know, it makes perfect sense to me, and it seems to be making perfect sense to you. So thank you all so much for that. We just really appreciate it. Our sign is down as I record out here, and so the new sign will be up probably in a week or so. And so we've got some good things ahead for us, even in the midst of all the COVID craziness. We've got some good things ahead, and we're mourning for those who are hurting in this area as well. And so we're grateful to God for keeping our family safe and keeping us safe, but it is crazy out there. And we're grateful for some calm and peace within our households and within our church. And that's only by God's grace. And that's what I wanted to encourage you in today, really, is to really make sure that as we check in and rechecking the foundation of our church, that you are also checking and rechecking the foundation of your household. A couple of months ago, we were preaching through this whole idea of making sure that we have a biblical household, and really making sure that those households were built upon the rock. And I was talking to one of our families this week, and this brother reminded me, he actually sent me a copy of his family mission statement that was inspired by those series of messages. And so I wanted to kind of share a screen with you here real quick. And show, he gave me permission to show you what he came up with. And so I want you to take a look at it. Let's see if I can get it here. That's not the right one. No, that's not the right one. Well, actually, this is the stuff concerning the mission statement. You might recall this. Remember, the message was called A Biblically Healthy Household. This was the fifth iteration. And I'll put the links to all of the messages in the email that you're looking at now, hopefully. But in point number three, it talked about working out your specific family purpose in prayer and in God's word. And we talked about the power of after your family has declared, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. After that has happened, then what? How do you codify that, right? How do you, you know, what do you write that down? How do you unify, rally the family around that? And we went over how powerful vision can be. Gives us direction, gives us motivation, helps us prioritize, builds our faith, helps us and forces us, quite frankly, to be disciplined. And so that question I had was, does your family have a mission statement? Does your family have a family covenant? And so if you can refer back to these notes, these are the same notes that we preached, and there were some links in those notes, and still are. Those links should be on our website, but there's some links in those notes to help you craft your family mission statement. And I'll see if I can pull it up. I hope I can pull it up. Are you going to let me pull this up here, homeboy? It doesn't want me to pull this up. Okay, there it is. This is the mission statement that was sent to me by one of our brothers, and he took his name out so I could show it to you. The such and such family mission statement, right? And he got this framed, and it's sitting up in his wall in his house somewhere. And I was just so inspired by this, and I was hoping that it would inspire you too. And so the such and such family mission statement. Our commitment to the Lord. This family is committed to serving the Lord Jesus Christ, praying together as a family unit, spending time in family worship and discipleship. And then he goes on to detail the commitment that the family will have to one another. You can read some of that there. We will be kind and tenderhearted, forgiving one another as Christ has forgiven us. That's a direct quote from scripture, I believe, Ephesians chapter 4. Communicate effectively. Tolerate our differences and ideas that don't contradict the principles of the gospel, so that we're going to love each other. In other words, we're going to support each other, going to be intentional about establishing vision and goals for the family that lead to, I love this, generational wealth and resources for our children. But it's not just about the family. The family then looks outside its four walls and says, here's our commitment to our neighbors. And so I love his motivation here and his faith here. We would strive to be world leaders. I love that. Game changers. You go ahead, Dad and Mom. Using our God-given talents. Keep justice and righteousness while rejecting any worldview, ideology, or mindset that's contradictory to the word of God. Work to maintain a good name and positive rapport with people, so on and so forth. And then he says, this is the legacy of our family as detailed in our mission statement. and then broke out with the generation to generational vision established on such and such a day. So I was just inspired by that. I thought you might be as well inspired by that. And, you know, my family actually has one that we're working on. He's got further than I am. But here's ours that we're working on. We don't have it framed and stuff yet, but the McLeod family mission and covenant, you know, our mission of our family is to serve the Lord in all we do and to honor and obey his word. Got some scripture there. And then there's that we lay out this covenant that in our family, God has no rivals, that in our family, we will love God and each other biblically, that in our family, the word of God will be taught, that in our family, the word of God will be lived and obeyed, that in our home, it's God's territory. That whether we have more than enough or just enough, we will not forget God. That in our family, we will attend church worship as a family. And there could be some other things that we add in there. We're still kind of working through ours. This is some stuff that I came up with years ago, but Don and I need to do a little bit more work on it and bring the children in on it a little bit better. But I want to encourage you guys in this whole mindset and gals in this whole mindset of establishing your household. What a great time to do it. It's again July as I'm sending this out to you, and mid-July. And, you know, what a time to pull the family together and say, hey, you know, we've had a chance to reset and refocus. Where are we going? What is God saying? What does the word say? So I just want to encourage you in that today. And as I said, the links to all of those five parts of those sermons are in this email. I tried to put this together where you'd feel comfortable sending it to people. Who do you know? I mean, we've gotten feedback and reports from people in other states concerning this series. Who do you know that who you know, from a family perspective, who might be inspired and blessed by working their way through these series of messages? And maybe you can help them out with that. Maybe it's somebody in another state. Maybe it's somebody right down the street. So I want to encourage you to send these out to people so that they might be blessed. Hey, I love you a lot. I pray that you're doing well. The church is doing well. We miss some of you, but we see you watching, and we're very grateful. We don't know how long all this is going to go on, but our commitment is to keep preaching and teaching and loving you and striving to be better leaders and servants to you. And we'll just see what the future holds. When you're ready to come back, for some of you, we'll, by God's grace, we'll be here. If we, you know, if this thing trends on a little longer, then we'll keep on going. And hopefully the Lord will be honored. Remember, the kingdom doesn't stop. Jesus is still saving people. He is still interested in your life and all that you're going through. He knows how you feel. He knows where your fears are. Make sure you're trusting him. Make sure you're praying. Make sure you're reading your word every day. Make sure you're doing family worship. Make sure that you are taking care of your body. Make sure you tone back on some of the news, because it can be discouraging and take your mind in crazy places. Make sure you keep your mind stayed on the Lord. Love you all. Happy Monday. Happy week. Here for you if you need us. And Lord willing, we'll see you soon.